Okay, I've got this call. All right, welcome everybody to another episode of The Coach's Show. I'm your host, Eric. With me as always, Coach Kimmy. Today's episode is brought to you by Social Distance. Great food, great fun. Go see them up in Satellite Beach and check them out. So we're here again in the Scorps Iron Paradise, and we're going to fill you in on the highlights from Friday night's game, as well as what's planned for this week against O'Galley. Coach Kimmy, welcome.
Yeah, awesome.
Well, let's jump right into it. Friday night's game against Lake Howell.
Yeah.
It was an amazing start to the season, a commanding 37-0 victory. What were your thoughts and takeaways?
Well, I mean, I think there were just so many unknowns going into the game. You know, we didn't get to play kickoff classic, so you know, you just don't ever know what your team's going to be till they get out there. I mean, you see them in practice, you see them in the weight room, you know who they are, but like until you test it against, you know, the fire of another opponent, it's really hard to tell. So it was just good to see us in live game action with the, you know, with the real things happening all around them, not just in a practice setting, and to see them perform that way. So I think a lot of questions were answered for us from the coaching staff side of it, and I was just really proud of their effort, and I thought they played a very clean game, and there wasn't a lot of misbehavior, and you know, typically that can start in that first week. Kids kind of forget how to play football, you know, in the within the rules, you know, and they need reminders, and I thought we did a great job with that, and you know, no dumb penalties or anything like that. So I just thought, you know, we had a really clean game, and represented our school and our community very well out there in Orlando.
We did,
and it was a great night.
Good amount of fans in the stands. Everybody came up. We even had somebody mention that they usually don't have this many cars come for away teams.
We travel well. Yes, we do.
You know, and the team, they came out like they had something to prove. They really came out with high energy, almost a chip on their shoulder. I mean, from the first possession, defensive possession, you know, I mean, Gabe Betts in the backfield, hits the quarterback, knocks the ball loose, runs it, you know, 6 points. I mean, immediately, right after the word go. And then the first offensive possession, one of Eddie's first touchdowns of the night. I mean, like I said, they were just firing on all cylinders.
Yeah.
And it was fun to watch. It was really enjoyable.
It was definitely put on a show, for sure. No, I think the our word of the week was violence. That was our theme. And, you know, we just challenged them to say, like, whatever you do, do it with, you know, the physicality that we expect. And I obviously defensively, I mean, they played extremely physical all night. And offense isn't always necessarily about physicality in the sense of physical physicality. Offense is a little more cerebral, you know, it's more mental violence. But I thought our offensive line, our two tackles, did a great job. Logan Ivey, Corbin Conley, they were physically violent. But overall, I just thought Gage Malkin played lights out.
Yeah, he did. He had a great game.
Put balls where they, you know, really could only be caught by the receiver, and you know, didn't make any major mistakes or turnovers, and you know, so I just thought from that perspective it was a clean game, great execution on both sides of the ball. Special teams to me were very sloppy. I mean, we got to get better there. But we're going to fix it this week, and obviously we got a big test coming up on Friday.
Be a, you know, you always got to walk away with something to tune up.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Especially being week one.
Still so much to do.
Yeah. With the strengths of the game, it was really, really fun. I'd like to take a chance and thank one of our other sponsors, Dawson Law. If you need any real estate or escrow legal help, check out Dawson Law, and they got a team of experts there ready to help you out. Coach, I mean, I know I've talked about my highlights. What was yours? What was your, you know, pivotal favorite moment of the game? Just got you fired up.
I thought, just really my always favorite part is just being on the sidelines with the team and the energy that you can feel and the energy of the stands and the cheerleaders. And I think last week losing out on that game, or a couple of weeks ago, was just such a reminder of how quickly things can go away. And so being on the sidelines with everybody and the coaches and the players and the managers and the cheerleaders and the fans and the stands and football's happening, I think that was just my favorite part, that we were on the field, you know?
You can't take it for granted anymore.
No, you know, you can't. It can legitimately, you know, one day we could be shut down. And so I just think, I just was happy to be out there and watch them. I mean, because these kids, they've worked so dang hard, you know? And losing out on a game 2 weeks ago is such a heartbreaker for them, because they're the ones that put in the sweat work all the time, and you know, they have all the sweat equity bought into it.
Exactly.
And so I was just glad they got to actually play a football game. Exactly. So I think anytime we were out there on the field, that was my highlight. But you know, obviously there were some great individual highlights, but that was my favorite part.
Yeah. Second half seemed to be a lot of penalties mm-hmm. thrown, and not most of them didn't go our way. But what it did is it also slowed the pace of the game.
Yeah.
It really kind of took the pace down, and probably the amount of actual plays we ran down.
Yeah.
There was the one punt that I think we wasted 3 minutes of game clock just mm-hmm. them getting that one punt off.
Right.
What are your thoughts on that?
You know, I challenged the team at halftime and just said, you know, like, what kind of team are we going to be? You know, are we the team that, you know, that can finish a game and not worry about what the score says at halftime? Or are we just going to coast our way through this and be sloppy? And, you know, I thought I saw a mixture of both. You know, there were some moments where I thought we could have been a lot cleaner and, you know, made some better decisions. But, you know, we also, you know, when you get to over 35 points, it's a running clock. So we didn't get to – you know, run as many plays as we did in the first half because the clock's running for most of the fourth quarter. But overall, you know, I just thought we could have been a lot cleaner, you know. And the refs are the refs. I mean,
yeah,
can't control
right?
that.
I mean, you even had your own 15 yards.
Oh, yeah, yeah, so. Yeah. I was pretty frustrated. And, you know, just for the people at home, you know, I typically don't get upset with referees unless it has to do with the safety of our players.
Mm-hmm.
And That was the main reason. There was an issue. You know, he had made a couple calls with blindside blocks that he called them, and on a kickoff, one of our players was legitimately blindside blocked, like the true definition of a blindside block. And the guy that had called it two plays before that was standing right there and did not throw the flag. And that to me is a major issue. So
yeah.
I don't ever lose it unless it has to do with protecting our kids, you know.
It's,
you know, holding calls, offsides, whatever, pass interference, whatever, that is what it is. You can't ever change anybody's mind, but man, like, if you're not going to protect our players, that's when I have an issue.
You have to protect the kids.
Yeah.
I mean, that's
yep.
one of the main
And that's why I got frustrated. He needed to hear it, so
good.
It's all good.
Well, good. I got everybody fired up.
Yeah.
So I know the kids were behind you when coach gets a penalty. They were the whole team took that penalty.
Yeah.
And they took
yeah.
it with pride.
They did.
I know that
they did.
So,
they did.
Take another moment. Thank one of our great sponsors, Beachside Bagel. They've been around and they've been a sponsor of Satellite High School, not mm-hmm. just Cork football, but all of Satellite.
Beachside Bagel World, yeah.
Forever. So yeah. Beachside Bagel World. Go check them out. Great bagels, great sandwiches,
yeah.
great people supporting the community of Satellite Beach. Coach, this week coming up, O'Gallagher.
Yeah.
First home game, first, you know, home opener. What are your thoughts? What's the game plan? What are you thinking for Friday?
I did want to close out one individual player that I thought defensively. You know, we mentioned Gage Malkin and Eddie Combs. I mentioned the tackles. I thought that offensively those guys really stood out to me. Defensively, I thought Ben Morrow had a great night. John Vion had
night. Very active. Ben Morrow, good to see him back.
Yeah. Bobby Clark, man, mm-hmm. he was all over the field.
Yeah, he had the punt block.
Mm-hmm. So I'm just really proud of that. I thought defensively as a whole, they executed the game plan very well. Anytime you're facing an option team, it can be tough. And so mm-hmm. everybody did their job. And then in special teams, you know, our special teams captain is Jake Palmer, and I thought, man, he just had a heck of a night on special teams. And he was like our sideline vocal leader and just
yeah.
did such a great job keeping players positive and engaged. So mm-hmm. I'm proud of those guys. I wanted to recognize them before we got to O'Galley. But, you know, moving on to O'Galley, you know, you're talking about a team that went to the Final Four, you know, or Final Eight or something last year, and they made a deep playoff run the year before. There's a lot, right? There's a lot of storyline on this game from previous years. You know, I'm not going to get too much into it, but you know, this is one of those weeks that, like, if you don't come ready to play and you don't have that burning desire to, you know, get out there and represent your school and your team with pride and go out there and dominate, then there's something wrong with you. Like, this is one of those weeks. So, you know, we're in a district. You know, playoff points matter.
Mm-hmm.
Every single game matters. So. If you want to make it to the playoffs, you got to win every game.
Yep.
So that's the only easy way guaranteed to do it. So, you know, this is a championship week in our minds.
Yep, absolutely.
And I know they're not in our district. And I mean, in the sense of our district, that, you know, doesn't necessarily count. But, it counts towards our points, and so we're treating it just like a championship game, just like we did last week. And
they all are, really.
Yeah, and you know, we know a lot of those guys, and I know the kids know some of those guys over there, and you know, there's just a lot on this game, and you know, we don't have to do anything outside of ourselves. We just got to play with, you know, what we're capable of doing, and you know, let the chips fall as they may. Mm-hmm. But you know, the mindset of physicality doesn't change. So you know, we want to you know, GATA and and continue to grow and develop offensively and clean up some of that stuff special teams wise from last game. And I think we're just be just fine. It's gonna be a packed house. Make sure you get your ticket early, and it's gonna be a awesome home atmosphere. I'm fired up about. And,
get there early. Get your parking early. Get your tickets early.
Yeah, it's gonna
get
be
in the gate.
Really, 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 really packed. This is a game that a lot of people have been looking forward to for a long time. So excited for it on Friday.
Absolutely. So are we, Coach. As always, thank you for joining us. And after the fantastic victory Friday night, it was a huge statement to open the season with.
Yeah.
Thank you to all of our fans for tuning in and supporting us. Supporting the Scorps. Don't forget, what you just said, Friday night, first game, home game against O'Galley, kickoff 7 p.m.
7 p.m.
Get there early. Don't forget to like, share the videos, and subscribe to the channel.
We also have a JV game at home on Thursday at 6 o'clock well.
Good point. Yes, 6 p.m. against Merritt and
Melbourne. Yep, Jamboree.
A Jamboree. 6 p.m. home for the JV.
So we'll two home games this week.
Perfect. Two home games this week. So we will see you all at the stadium. So we'll see you Friday night. Stay safe and go Scorps.
Go Scorps.
Okay, I've got this. Come on, this Bugatti. I'm strong in this Bugatti. 2B8s ain't no.